Hey guys, I want to share a painting with you. I did this a couple years back, or I think a few years back. And this is the picture of Jesus that I painted. I have had a vision of him in 2020 three times. And now I know this is not what he looks like here. I would say he looks more like angry or mad, but in true reality, he is beautiful, and he is lovely. Eyebrows are not like this. His eyes are beautiful. His cheeks, his nose, his face, everything. So this is just something I painted before I seen his beautiful face shining on me in 2020, open eye vision. But anyway, this is something I want to share with you guys because I see it all the time, and I think it's one of the best paintings I ever painted in my life. And at the same time, I love color. I enjoy God's beauty and his work. He's an artist himself, and the colors that he brought to the earth, I just love to splash that around everywhere and anywhere I could think of. So this is his creation through me. Ever since I was small, I've always had a thing for art, so wanted to share that with you guys. Also, I did not only just come on here to show a painting, but I wanted to tell you about the goodness of Jesus and his love for people who love him. Even if they don't even know him, they don't know how much they're loved by him. And he has blessed me with financial support, enough to be able to find a place, an apartment, with my girls, and to even furnish it. So I'm, because of all the prayers and because of the grace and mercy of God, I am able to look for a place. And I don't know how to be more than thankful, but we do serve a beautiful, loving God. And he says that even though we're wicked, we're evil, but we know how to give good gifts to our children, but with him, he's holy. What kind of gifts can he give us? The blessings are just more than what we could ever think of giving our children. Today I looked in my account, my new account, and more money had come from, I don't know why, but I really believe it's God. I really believe it's Jesus. And so I just wanted to share that part with you guys, that if you are struggling like me, I'm almost to the finish line of this journey so that I can be able to tell a testimony. You guys have no idea how long I've been in this. He called me the moment I surrendered my life 10 months ago. And he didn't waste any time to tell me what he wanted from me, to live a holy, blameless life, and to move away from my children's father. And I had to go under his authority and, just being controlled. And before him, I was very outgoing, and I was always out doing face paintings and always doing art gigs and murals and all kinds of things. And I was a cosmetologist, and so I was always doing hair and nails and makeup and weddings and things like that. And as soon as I met this guy, all that pretty much just went down the drain, and I just stayed in this house and just painted all this time, all these years, and just kept things to myself. And, you know, he would say, "Oh, you don't need to sell your stuff. You just keep it and or just give it away." And, you know, just very controlling about what I should ever do. And I'm not saying I'm not a giver. I love to give. That's all I've ever seen myself doing ever. But God has something more. He has something more for me. And he told me one day, he said this, "Trust me." And he said it so lengthy and so soft. And so I finally said, "You know what? I get dreams often, and I know I've seen myself many times with just me and my girls doing our own thing. And the last thing I saw was us walking into an apartment, and it was meant for just us. And it was empty, and we just brought in the stuff we had in our hands. And I just said, you know what, Jesus, I believe you're going to give me a place. I believe there's going to be something you're going to do for me that you are already doing. You may sound a little quiet, but you're doing something. You're in the middle of doing something." And as soon as that happened, I received income. I received money. And for that, I'm just seeing more coming in. And this is the second time already. So Jesus is such a loving and giving God. If I love to give, I love making paintings and I love making art and giving them away. Even my artwork has even paid my bills before, you know. It has really gotten me by. The therapeutic part about it, oh my goodness, it has really got me through emotional things in my life. And God is calling me more. He's calling me more into what he has given to me. He gave me this talent, and all I can do is be that good and faithful servant and do something with it. So right now I'm in the middle of calling people in different communities, four locations, to set up a God's garden and have a bunch of artwork of stones all around it. And I'm actually speaking to somebody who is going to make me the sign to put God's garden, and on the bottom, take a rock, leave a rock. And I'm asking people of all ages, artists or not artists, to paint on rocks and just to put a scripture, put a favorite verse, put something of encouragement on the stones, so that we can give it to people in these areas, so that it could speak some revelation to them, it could say something to them. So I wanted to share that because that is one way I have asked God. I said, "Well, you know, you have given me the ability of art to paint. How can I use my artistic ability, my talent, my only gift to spread the gospel, the good news?" And the only thing I received in me that day was rocks. And I said, "Why didn't I think about it before?" So if you look, I have a short video that I had made in November. I've made over 200 plus stones, and my kids also helped me as well. But what I had did with that is put scriptures in the back, and everybody who had taken a rock, I heard, this was in San Jose, California, I had heard from people in San Jose, California, tell me that all the rocks were gone. And I was just so excited, because I was like, wow, that is the best thing ever. People had the chance to take a gift from my gift that was given to me, to take it home with a smile on their face, and to be able to turn it over and to see that it has a verse on it. They're able to look that up and feed a little bit, feed their spirit a little bit, some food, some spiritual food, manna. Jesus says, I am the manna. And so with that, I was able to feed hungry souls, and through my artwork. And it's not me, it's Jesus. I know he's right here. I know he's right here right now, because the light, the presence of the Holy Spirit, I can see the brightness on Jesus' face. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. So I wasn't expecting to come on here and start crying, you guys. But I know Jesus has a better life for me. And it's not the life that I'm living right now, where I'm just stuck in a bubble waiting on someone's commands. Because he told me that if I stay under my children's father, under his authority, that I was going to perish, that I was going to die. And I believe God. But he is calling me to go under his authority, because it's better for me. And I'm ready to go. I'm ready to see what he has for me. And if my art can bring the gospel and good news to their hearts as planting a seed, then Jesus has all the living water, and I can't wait for him to water these seeds. So we serve an amazing God. Don't ever doubt that. It's true. Well, you guys have a beautiful day. And thank you so much for your prayers. For those of you who are praying, you guys have no idea that this is a train leading to something greater. So thank you.